गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, यू आर मोस्ट वेलकम इन दिस सेशन। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू केमिस्ट्री ऑफ क्लास 7। ओके, इन प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव टॉट यू सॉइल एंड फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द सॉइल। ओके, सो हियर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द सॉइल प्रोफाइल। यू मे हैव विजिटेड कोल माइंस एंड वेयर डिगिंग इज बीइंग डन, so you may have seen the side of that ditch, there is different layers and each layer differs from the texture, color, depth and chemical composition like this। I have made one figure। Now here you may have seen that this is the figure of the side of a ditch। Okay, so here first that is top soil is said, so different layers are divided into a horizon। Okay, and each horizon have some features, which is the topmost, that is this A horizon। Okay, and second that is B horizon, third that is C horizon। Okay, each layers is divided into some features। What is the feature? According to texture, color, depth and chemical composition। Okay, so that layers is known as horizon। The topmost layer is known as the A horizon, the second is known as the, which is just built under the A horizon, that is says B horizon, and under that is C horizon। In three layers the soil is divided, okay, and the basic is this one: texture, color, depth and chemical composition। So first layer, now I explained that A horizon, what is the quality of the A horizon? It is in black color first, that is in dark color, okay, or black, you can say black in color, and second is it is made of tiny particles of the rocks or stones, and third that is rich in humus, that's why the top layer is fertile, okay, and due to fertility it can grow the plants can be grown here। I make plants, but okay, so in top layer, it means in A horizon, plants are grown, okay, plants can survive here, okay, why? Because it is made of tiny particles of the rocks or stones, and humus is found here in this layer, that's why it is fertile, and because it is made of tiny particles, that's why it can hold water also, it can hold water, and humus is present, that's why a plant can survive। These are the features, and also this part is the many insects and reptiles can survive in this place, it is the home। Top layer is home of some insects and reptiles also, okay, so what is the features? A horizon, that is dark in color, very fine particles, second humus, okay, third, fourth number soft, porous and can hold more water, okay, and fifth, that is the home also for some insects। I hope it is clear, and the second layer, it means second layer B horizon, that is C same B horizon also known as the subsoil and the top which is the A horizon this is known as also topsoil okay A horizon is also known as topsoil and the second which is just below the A horizon is known as B horizon and the second name is subsoil and what are the features that just opposite here it is dark color here it is a little light in color okay and here it is very fine particle is found here but here the particle is slightly bigger larger okay so slightly harder and larger also okay and that is A horizon is rich in humus and it is in second layer or B horizon the humus it is found means little humus is found in B horizon okay and third that is rich in soluble minerals and iron oxide this is the means biggest feature biggest quality of B horizon that it is rich in minerals soluble minerals and iron oxide okay so that is B horizon and third layer that is C horizon it is the particles are that is the larger that's why it is a small piece of hard stones and rocks C layer is made of small pieces of hard stones and rocks also okay and it is very difficult to dig beyond the sea horizon okay and after the sea horizon bedrocks are found bigger rocks are found here okay I hope you got it in brief soils according to the different layers of the soil it is divided into some parts first that is A horizon second B horizon and third is C horizon okay A horizon is also known as topsoil B horizon is also known as subsoil okay and the features we have discussed about that points okay you can do that now I am going to teach you the types of the soil now I am going to teach you types of the soil okay so now soil first soil word derived from a word that is solum which means earthy material okay soil is derived from solum which means earthy material okay so you know the top soil of the earth is very important for growing plants so top soil contains some small parts of the rocks and which divided into some parts that is clay particles silt particle sand particle and gravel this type of four types of rocks are found in the top soil and these are different in size okay so first that is clay particle is less than 0.005 millimeter okay this is the smallest particle okay and the silt particle this the size of the silt particle is between 0.005 to 0.05 millimeter okay and third is sand particle size is 0.05 millimeter to 2 millimeter okay. And fourth is, that is said gravel. Gravel is a small stone that you can pick up by hands also, okay. So in that soil which is found maximum in size, according to that we divide the soil into three parts, okay. First, that is sandy soil. In sandy soil, the amount of the sand is larger, okay, maximum, okay. And the silt and the clay particle is in minimum. Here sand particle, that is in the larger amount, and silt and clay, that is in smaller amount, okay. You know the sand particle, the size of the sand particle is 0.05 to 2 millimeter. That's why it is in a little larger. So, suppose that this is the sand particle. In sand particle, it is larger inside. That's why the gap between sand particles can hold air, okay. So it can hold air also. Air can trapped between the holes of the sand particles. That's why it is airy, okay. Light, well aerated and dry, okay. And you know the gap between sand particles, that contain gaps. That's why when it falls rain, when it rains, rain water can drip easily. That's why it cannot hold water, okay. So the feature of the sandy land is, it is found in deserts, okay. And second, cannot hold water because the sand particles is airy, it trap the air. That's or also you can say the gap, there is a smaller gap between the sand particles. That's why it cannot hold water, it can trap easily, okay. And not suited for crops, growing crops, for agriculture it is not suited, okay. That's why in desert we cannot grow plants, okay. Only some special types of plants can be grown in that area, okay. So light also, the feature is light and well aerated and dry, okay. And second is clay soil. Here clay soil is made of, that is mix of clay, humus and silt. You know clay, here the amount of the clay, it is larger, and humus and the silt, that is in smaller, okay, amount. Clay is a larger amount. When you touch the clay, it is a little smooth in touch. It is smooth in touch, okay. That, and it is very tiny, that's why it is closed pit each other. The gap between two particles is smallest. There is no gap between two particles. That's why it can hold water, okay. So what is the features of the clay soil? Closely pit. Second, hold water and cannot trap air. When the gap between the two particles is minimum, that's why it cannot trap air, okay. And it is good for agriculture because it contains minerals. In clay soil, we can grow plants. We can do the agriculture. Okay, and third, that is loamy soil. In Hindi, it is a domat mitti. Okay, so in loamy soil, clay particle, silt, sand, and humus are mixed in right proportion. Here, all that things are mixed in right proportion. Here, no any things, no any particle is more or less. It is mixed in right proportion. That's why it is good water holding and it reasonably porous to allow aeration to of roots. It gives aeration of more air when you need them. Only then for getting air we plow the field. Okay. And third, that is best suited for growing plants. Why? Because it can hold water, it is right proportion in humus, sand, silt and clay. That's why it is suited for agriculture. So the best soil is loamy soil. In loamy soil we can grow plants, whatever you want you can do the farming. Okay, I hope it is clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask in Zoom meeting class. That's all for today. Have a good day. Bye.